Assalamu alaikum, how are you? Thank you for the scientific committee to give us this opportunity to present this type of cases and sharing with our colleague, with you, Dr. Ali Asiri, as an assistant professor in Najran University Department of Pediatric Dentistry. Today we will present one of my cases that done under local anesthesia with one of the sophisticated department that is called special care dentistry. As an introduction for the diastrophic dysplasia, it is a rare skeletal dysplasia first described by Lamy in 1960. Approximately 150 cases have been described in the literature. And the diastrophic as a terminology, it is a Greek word meaning twisted or bent. The disease, it is an inherited autosomal recessive manner. The condition affect male and female in the same frequency, and as a frequency it is 1 in 500,000 births in United States and 1 in 30,000 births in Finland. So it is the Finland, it is the high incidence in all over the world. As a clinical feature for this type of patient or this type of disease, we will go one by one. First of all, they have short limb dwarfism, as you can see in this patient, short limb dwarfism. He has also the hypertrophic auricular cartilage over the time. This will transform into stiff and it will call cauliflower ears. And also they have the most common also feature that you will see with this type of patient, severe talpus equinovarus, and this called club feet associated with great malposition of the toes. And also ulnar division of hand, and this also called Hitchhiker thumb. As you can see in this picture, the thumb, and there is ulnar deviation, this is called Hitchhiker sign. And also they have malformation also in the skeletal of the back, as flexion, contraction or subluxation, dislocation for the hip and knee, and progressive scoliosis and kyphosis or lordosis. And these three terminology, as you can see what is a scoliosis and also what is a scoliosis, it is important for you when you are going to make patient under general anesthesia, and this is might be make the risk for cord compression. And also one of the features, it's progressive increase in the curvature of the lower spine, it is called lordosis, as we said before. And in this diagram you can differentiate it between these three terminology, kyphosis as well as lordosis and the scoliosis. These three things it's important to know, especially when you are going to put patient under general anesthesia. This is might cause a spinal cord compression. And they have also dental feature or characteristic for diastrophic dysplasia patient. There is about 1/3 of these patients, they have hypodontia, and many will develop bite abnormality, and most common anterior, narrow anterior palate and open bite and cross bite. About 30 to 50% from this type of patient, they will have K-left palate. There is a consideration for a pediatric dentist or a general dentist when he is going to treat such patient by this disease, he should put this point in his mind to be emphasizing that during his treatment, like establish the most comfortable position in the chair and demonstrate its security. Use compressed air and water spray with special care, especially when the patient have a cleft palate. Avoid excessive impression material when the patient have also a cleft palate. Take special care to taking intraoral radiographic cleft also. Avoid prolonged position in the dental chair to avoid respiratory distress and possible complication of kyphosis and scoliosis. Use equipment and instrument improperly to avoid upsetting and harming of this type of patient. And during anesthesia for this type of patient, the diastrophic dysplasia are prone to cavernosclerosis, which make breathing difficult and may lead to long-term lung problem and unstable neck, mean that general anesthesia is potentially a high-risk procedure in this type of patient. our case that we are treating, and that previous it was a hint or an introduction regarding the type of syndrome. Our patient, he is a 9 years old Saudi male living in Al Madina Al Munawwara, and as a history for family and social, he is from consanguineous parent, and he is the sixth rank among 8 siblings, and there is no significant for family disease. For past medical history, he has multiple developmental anomaly. It's called dystrophic dysplasia. His pregnancy period was full time with normal, and birth condition was term lower segmental caesarean section. And current medication, he didn't use any medication. And about the history for hospitalization several time because of congenital anomaly, and the vaccination, it is regularly and up to date. And this is the referral, this is the medical report that he's bringing from his specialist. By the examination for extraoral, as you can see for our patient, the terminology that we can cauliflower ear, that is hypertrophic, and with the time it will come stiff, and the patient, he has this ear, he cannot hear about it, and from this ear he can hear from that. And Hitchhiker sign that we said before, ulnar deviation, it is very frank in this patient. As well as the club feet or talpus equinovarus, as you can see in our patient, he has absent of these, and he has also extra 2 in the both legs, 6 here and 6 in the other side. And the scaphosis, it is very important when we are want to treating our patient under general anesthesia. According to the CARES risk assessment tool, our patient is considered as a high CARES risk. So it is important to try to protect our patient or prevent from further destruction for his mouth health, for oral health. We go through the diagnostic aid. We first take OBG for our patient. It's normal developing dentition. No supernumerary teeth are detected. Upper and lower permanent canine appear to be erupted normally. We take also full mouth radiograph. As you can see, 2 bite wing and 4 periapical with 2 occlusal radiograph. And we take intraoral picture. As you can see in our patient, for example, he has an attrition, and he has an crossbite with retained deciduous teeth. And here this tooth, it is retained root and with erupting premolar. And he has also here hypoplasia as well as multiple dental caries. We talk a cast, we do for space analysis for our patient. Our result, it was there is adequate space for a patient. As a diagnosis, he has multiple dental caries, and he has an unilateral single anterior crossbite. Our treatment plan considers phases, behavior management case, because our patient is a special care patient. He need a behavioral management, and we start about preventive phase till bit fissure sealant, fluoride application, diet counseling, oral hygiene instructions. We go to the restorative and surgical phase. We do bulb therapy for the tooth that is need bulb therapy, and we restore the remaining tooth, and we put a steel crown to coverage for hypoplastic teeth, and as an coronal seal, or as it is the better and the best solution for patient with high caries risk, especially when he is special care dentistry. And we go to the orthodontic phase for correction of anterior crossbite. As a revision, as you can see, this our patient photo before treatment or perioperative, and here our photo after we finishing from patient treatment, but still we are not starting the ortho treatment. As you can see, or as you see before in this picture, you cannot see the frontal teeth to number tooth number 21. But here after we extracted the root, the retained root, as you can see here, the tooth 21 is visible, but still not erupted. So it need an orthodontic appliance to correct. We design this is a fixed band, and with the jack screw, that patient will, according to the instruction, they will activate it daily to correct this type of crossbite. As you can see here before, and here after the crossbite correction. Now As you can see, it is corrected crossbite, but the gingival is still hypertrophy, so the tooth it is equal in length, but here is their pseudo bucket around 9 millimeters. So we decided by after we do for the patient examination for the labial frenum, we see the blanching test. So we decided the periodontologist to do both in one time gingivectomy as well as frenotomy to prevent the food impactions or vouching of food, and it will clean area. It is simple and easy for this type of patient. We do it in one sitting under local anesthesia, all our treatment done. Here as a revision in the bite before the end of this presentation, here all the periapicals and bite wings before starting our treatment, and here photo before, as we see, as we said before, here our x-ray after 6 months from treatment. As you can see, bulb therapy done on of the most of the tooth, and we do still steel crown for the tooth that is hypoblastic filling is done. And here the photo after 6 months, here see the correction of crossbite and how's the occlusion established for the patient, fissure sealant it's applied for the first permanent molar. And here can you see the differentiation in patient smile. So in our case, we do re-establishing of the innocent smile for this special care patient. Thank you for listening. Thank you.